All right, hey, it's Death Ray. Another early morning work. I just got off, so needed to get a couple of things done, and I figured, what the hell, I might as well get it uploaded and ready to go. Let y'all see what I'm doing. I'm sure there are 15 million videos out there for how to do Guardian this, Guardian that, and but I figured, I'm not the experts, so you can see the mistakes, you can see what I do and go from there and maybe learn from it, maybe not, who knows? But I like to at least share, so that's what I'm going to do today. So yesterday I did a weapon sight. Today I'm doing a video or a vehicle sight, the fighter vehicles. I've done it once already, did it yesterday. Wanted to get a feel for it before I put it out there. Sorry about the yawn. Like I said, just got off of late night at work. Right. So, a little more activity here than I expected. Or at least a little more activity here than the other sites that I've run for the modules and for the weapons. I didn't do a video for the modules. If you want me to, I can go back and do one. That's not a problem. I'm actually not that far off from a module site. So if that's something that you want to see, let me know. Put it in the chat, send me a message, whatever, and I will try to get out there and get that done for you, just so you can see it, at least from my perspective and how I do it. But anyway, so we'll get this ball started.
Gravity warning.
Okay, so the site is pretty much similar to other sites. It's got the main part up there where everything is. No, I can't even think what I want to call it. Focal point? I don't know. Where you get your blueprint. Hello. Like to do that. Okay, so like I said, up here at the top. Altar, that's the word I'll call it. Altar. Oh, hello. Alright, so ultimately this is where you're gonna start everything off. Obviously there are going to be drones just like everything else. This place, or at least this one. Hey, oh, there is another drone here. peekaboo. When I did it yesterday, there were a lot more drones than normal, but it's still manageable. So don't think that you can't get it done or non-functional or you're gonna need help. You could still do it solo. But the key is going to be getting the pylons, which are these things right here, charged up. And to get them started, you have to come up here and get these two activated. Start off. Now the other pylons are going to be, as most of the sites I've seen, you're going to have one to the left, you're going to have one to the right, you're going to have one in the center, and then one way down there in the center as well. So you've got a total of six. So we'll get this started. As always, there's going to be a timer to go along with it. Target down there. There it is. I was trying to remember where it was. So there's the right one. As you can see, there are targets everywhere. Come up over here. Take him down first. Then focus on this one. Side. Once you clear them, once you get all of them, besides the ones that are already there, there will be more that pop up. So you now have, let's see, there's three, four, five different targets to shoot. So, but your timer's not active anymore, so you don't have to worry about getting the timer done beforehand.
Cargo scoop deployed.
I don't think I need it. I think I'm full of everything. So you're gonna take them out one by one, and of course, little strategy doesn't hurt. Now, the nice thing about this ship or this SRV is its accuracy from a distance. This thing is extremely accurate from a long way. So. Corners and shoot them from a long distance. The Scorpion, on the other hand, it's a better combat ship, better strength and shields, but its long game sucks. So you have to be right up on top of it for it to be really good and hard hitting. Which can be an advantage or disadvantage in itself, can be an advantage. Really, actually can be. The fact that I can shoot them and their shots are harder.
Target destroyed.
Shoot. Well, I can literally dodge their shots. Stock the ammo.
Weapons rearmed.
And then get back in the turret.
Target destroyed. Under attack.
Anymore, so it looks like we took care of all of them. Get back up here and we'll finish our process. Now, unlike the others, the vehicle sites don't take relics, they take the keys. Shit. Really get it. All right, back to the ship. Left it in the cargo.
Handbrake is on.
I tried a power slide. Alright. Oh, transfer. Alright. Try this again. Ancient key. Jettison. Starts its process. Back in the turret. Go to analyze mode. Don't remember. I think it's after the analyze mode that you actually get targets or your drones. But targets analyze. Scan it. And voila. You now have it. And that's when you start getting
under attack. Target destroyed.
And there's usually more than one. There's one. I want to say I had more than that last time. Not seeing any more. No? I think that did it. Now, just like all the other sites, this site has all the necessary items that you need to pick up, should you need to pick them up. So you'll have leaning towers around here. I want to say there's one right there. There's one right there. There's one right there. Got all the scattered little pieces that you can pick up, the urns and so forth. The relic towers, you've already seen those pop up when I was opening up the towers are right here. Power cell. Not need. Conduit. Not needed. What I need is technology. Technology. Sure, cargo's open.
Cargo scoop retracted. Cargo scoop deployed.
Let's try the other. Technology. Nope. Parcel. That's right. Technology's like a T, skinnier. But anyway, figured I'd give it a shot. But that's pretty much the extent of it. Like I said, other than a few more drones, you know, everything else is pretty much the same. Really easy to do. So we will reset, do it one more time, because there are only three fighters, so technically you don't need to get three keys. You can get one key, just do one fighter, or you can get all three keys. And I recommend getting the keys, and I'll get on all three of them before you come to the vehicle site, because you absolutely need the keys. Now you don't have to board to reset. All you got to do is log out, log back in. Reason I'm doing this is it allows me to repair or refuel, so forth and so on, doing it this way. So and anytime you do this, it takes 15 seconds to be able to log out. Then you log out. Log back in. Now, again, when doing this, like I said the last video, I recommend doing this in solo. And the reason for that, unless you're with a wing, when you do it in solo, you're doing it singular. It's you and only you in the site collecting the materials. You do it with a wing, or if you do it in open play, you are looking at having to share. So for instance, if you're in open play, and I was 2 days ago when I was doing, some of the vehicle stuff, there was another commander there doing the same thing, and you can't both get the blueprint. It's one blueprint per run. So if you've got two people in a wing, or you've got two people, two separate individuals in open play, only one person can get it. And then I can see where that will be. I'm sure if I wanted to be an absolute dickhead when he dropped the relic, I could have snatched the blueprint from under him by scanning it faster, but that's not my style. And that's, again, like I said, why I recommend doing this in open play. Or not open play, in solo. Nothing to do with being scared or anything like that. Now, if you're in a wing, you know, then y'all can help each other out. You pick who wants to get it at that point in time. The drones become a whole lot easier to take down because you got multiple people shooting at them. You know, it just becomes a whole lot easier, and usually playing with a group or with a friend is, you know, more fun. like there were more than one. There he is.
Target destroyed.
That it. So. Okay. Correctly, they were down in this gully. Yep, there they are. Alright. I heard him. There he is. Oh, there's two of them. I had another target over there. Looks like I've got another one over there. First center one. Sure, I don't have any targets. Second center one. Like I said, there's relics. So. Charged. Alright, so I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. there was another one over here. There he is.
Under attack.
To get the last key, didn't I?
Handbrake is on.
That was a much better slide. Eject. And there we go. So now, there's one. That's it. There's two. Okay. First. Just verify. Nothing else. All right. Voila, we'll get the three keys. Okay, we want to make sure that we get the prints. Vessel blueprints, 3. Alrighty. We are good to go. Like I said, there are only 3 vehicles, so you don't need more than 3 keys or 3 blueprints. Now, should later they come out with more vehicles or something like that, that's another story at that point in time.
London gear retracted. Frameshift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Alright. Now we need to get back to my carrier. Like to try to get at least 100 kilometers away from the surface before I start moving off in another direction, just to make sure I don't re-enter the atmosphere, because I've done that a couple of times. Well, between 100 and 400 is usually what I do.
Frameshift drive charging.
So, that's the basic gist of the vessel vehicle site. Other sites can be a little different, but the basic premises is always there. Same as modules, same with weapons. There are usually 6 pylons. There are going to be parts and things that you have to pick up at every site, so I recommend doing it, unless you've done it as many times as I have and just, you know, don't have room for them anymore, then, you know, there's no sense in trying.
Fuel sink disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
But, like I said, if you have any questions, don't hesitate in messaging me. You can find me on Discord, you can find me on YouTube, you can find me in the game. My name is the same all the way around. Well, actually, in YouTube, it's Mr. Deathray, but that's because some other guy had my name, believe it or not. If you like snowboarding or skiing, then I think he was if I remember correctly, he was a snowboarder, so, you know, if that interests you, yeah, go see his page.
Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging. Critical. Fuel scoop disengaged.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're almost there. Alright, so, as I said, you know, thanks for flying with Death Ray. Have any questions, feel free to let me know. As always, you know, hit that subscribe button so you, or that follow button so you can see more, you know when I come on, you know, so forth and so on. For those that drop by the channel, I appreciate it. Thanks for joining. It's always nice to have y'all by. But I will be signing off for now, posting this up on YouTube for other people to view. And then I should be back on a little bit later to actually do some real stuff, not just grinding for blueprints. But I will catch y'all later. Have a good one.